and through all the corporations in our country. See, the cost effectiveness of our engagement is 1/4, less than 1/4. And even in our system can work in remote areas where no diagnostic facilities are available. We can prescribe symptoms on the basis of unique symptoms which are produced by the patient, and those symptoms are the altered state in mind and body at particular time. So we are so handy. We can work on telemedicine. We can work in remote area. We work with very small arrangement. And I tell you, if world thinks about universal health care, I am sure keeping all the intrinsic values of homeopathy, homeopathy is the best possible treatment to provide universal health care. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I now request Dr. Manchanda, sir, please shed some light on what strategic actions are needed to place homeopathy on the roadway to integrated care. Sir, a very short comment of 1 to 2 minutes, please.
Thank you. When I look at, we have already listened to Dr. Dhamle, Dr. Gupta, and Dr. Patwardhan. But we have seen that there are certain areas where we have distinct advantage of homeopathy. And this debate of integrated medicine is not new. It is right from the beginning. When the homeopathic education policy was being laid down in Parliament, even at that point of time, there was a debate in 1967. I still remember when there was a Congress, there was a long lecture of Dr. Divan Harishchand. Can homeopathy be integrated as a medical system within the allopathy? That was the concern. Because in Europe, when we see the global situation, homeopathy has been given somewhere chair, somewhere department, and somewhere homeopathic education exists in non-university areas. But after a lot of debate, it was decided that if we have to develop homeopathy, and if we have to realize the real potential of homeopathy in clinical care, we need to say no to integration at the level of education. But there's a need to integration at the level of service providing setups. So Government of India adopted policy of cafeteria approach. All state governments are trying to follow with best of their ability. I have experience of Delhi government of following that cafeteria approach or integrating homeopathy, integrating other IELTS system into the allopathic under the same roof. CGHS colleagues do have that kind of experience. In between, there was a time when we were planning to expand these services. One of the finance ministry of Delhi government issued one order that, look, our budgets are limited. We have not been able to provide even one system. Why? You are talking of 3 systems under one roof. Is it beneficial? Is it going to increase the budget? What is the actual going on at ground level? Because at that time, we were having only 32 dispensaries in Delhi. So, an extensive survey by the external agency, planning department was done. And their findings were very, very interesting. A, cost of homeopathy treatment is 1/5 in terms of medicine. Second finding was that though it looks that the patient of respiratory systems are being treated by both the systems, but profile of patients is different. Patients, those who are opting for homeopathy, are mostly subacute and chronic patients, where they see that now they have to take long-term allopathic treatment, they prefer to take homeopathy, and during acute episode, they take allopathy systems. And the another finding, what they observed when they interviewed allopathic doctors, 87% allopathic doctors said that existence of homeopathy under the same premises is beneficial for the patient, for the system. I often quote saying of the then director health services, Dr. Jeevan Jha. She said that we should have homeopathy unit in every dispensary, because at least we can reduce the cost of antibiotics that is required to be given at least 3 to 4 times in a year for every influenza episode. this is how integration at service level is going on, and for which India is a unique model. The model that we adopted at the level of policy in education has also given us a rich dividend. That is why we are world leader, we are having infrastructure, we are doing independent research, we are thinking homeopathic about the homeopathic education independently. But when I look at research, research necessarily need to adopt all the modern biomedical techniques, all biomedical information. Those are required to be brought into homeopathy. Now, if I have to talk of only strategic things, so when I look at education, we need to have independent thinking in education. Now, fortunately, Government of India is at another crossroad when they are going to have a separate commission on homeopathy, and this commission is going to look after independently about the homeopathic education policy. But what this commission is required to think? This commission is required to focus on a curriculum that should give greater emphasis of homeopathy in public health. How homeopathy can be integrated in public health. For this, we did one experiment at the level of Central Council for Research in Homeopathy, where we adopted certain districts and we employed our research associates for giving homeopathy at the level of preclinical stage of all the lifestyle diseases. And even the person, those who are having these diseases, what kind of dietary modifications are required to be done, and if a person is even having late stage and are dependent on allopathic medicine, can we reduce those medicine? Can we delay the use of antihypertensive? Can we delay the use of anti-diabetic? And similarly, for so many mental health problems, at primary health level, these experiments of non-communicable diseases are giving. So there is a need to strategically integrate homeopathy, and in education, we have to focus more on public health subjects. We need to focus on modern pharmacology. Not for the purpose of prescribing those drugs, but to understand and to modernize those drugs according to the homeopathic terms. We need to focus on critical thinking at medical school level. Otherwise, the type of criticism, external criticism we are facing in homeopathy, if our doctors are not having insight critical thinking and are just focusing on the what Hahnemann said at that point of time, that will not be sufficient. We need to put that, analyze that with a critical prism. Another very important thing is adoption of good points of other systems in the curriculum without compromising on the basic concepts of homeopathy. That is very, very important. That somewhere, some of the things we have adopted, but still we need to adopt more. We are like teaching some of the homeopathic subject for so many hours that may not be necessary. And such kind of modern teaching tools are also required to be incorporated in education. Now, coming to the practice, knowledge of scope and limitation of different systems necessarily need to be told, and advantages of homeopathy needs to be properly spread. There is a need to promote referrals as is being done at our cafeteria approach at government level in CGHS, in various state government dispensaries. That needs to be further encouraged, analyzed. But for research, we need to necessarily collaborate. We need to necessarily collaborate with the latest that is going on in biomedical sciences. And I would just like to say some of the areas where CCRH have been able to, we from India have been able to collaborate. Is one was the development of the model for evaluating randomized controlled trials. So there are publications on that. There is a publication recent has come. This is about what we need to do if we have to design and if we have to publish observational studies. So what are those allopathic guidelines, stroke guidelines, and what needs to be add on from homeopathic point of view. Similarly, if we have to present a case from allopathic perspective, what special care we need to do for homeopathy. So there are care home guidelines. So all these publications, even read out guidelines for randomized controlled trial. So we need to adopt these, and with the type of infrastructure we have, I am very sure this is doable, and we only in the world can do that and show what can be the right model for homeopathy as regard integration is concerned. And in this regard, Government of India has already doing a lot of things, like they are giving equal status to the medical. These are the steps for that integration. If the status of the two doctors are different, they will not ever integrate. So now we have seen equal status in several state governments, in central government, so it is possible. Co-location is already one of the possibility. But what is very, very, sometimes surprised me is whether it is a possibility of intra-Ayush collaboration. Intra-Ayush integration is also there or not. So these are some of the thoughts I would just like to share at the beginning. As the discussion will evolve, I'll be able to share more about my perspective. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Next, I would like to ask Dr. B.N. Singh, sir, what message do you think the practitioners can carry from here to evolve in the area of integrative care? Just a few lines, sir.
It is very peculiar things which has been organized by Khurana Sahib. The integrative condition for the homeopathy, how it can be placed, how it can develop. And from the very beginning, we can say the knowledge of education Dr. Gupta has explained something from the very beginning, preclinical and clinical, just even the true surgical. Let the advancement of the homeopathy in the surgical cases, it has not been adopted till now. But in the purview of the medicine, we have to go through the very beginning. We have must be a knowledge of proper anatomy, physiology, and all the subjects. Then application of these subjects, even up to all, if you have the knowledge of pathology, you can just assess about the position of and the any factors. But it is only to manage the case. Diagnosis, but it may be, suppose it is a typhoid. We can diagnose the case is typhoid. But many of the typhoid cases, we cannot apply the single medicine to everyone. Similarly, we have to inculcate and develop the integrative way for the diagnosis of, just like that of the, we have to say the anamnesis. Diagnosis of the disease, diagnosis of the personality, diagnosis of the medicine, diagnosis of the frequency, diagnosis of the frequency, how it can be applied. So the integration to select the medicine and the application of applied the medicine and the managing the medicine. For the case of the typhoid, suppose we can select a medicine according to the personality, according to the totality of symptoms. But for the purpose of the management, we know it is a case of typhoid. What should be given in the food or how it can be managed according to gender. So we can, all the things are, it depends upon the case state. Selection of the medicine only depends upon the symptomatic condition. And diagnosis can be only on the basis of management. For the only, it can help in the management. This is the only thing. I can quote here about the
COVID-19.
In the COVID-19, you know, the corona infection is since 1964, and many times it has been. But in the last year, today, what is going on from the all sides, maybe from the government side, from the institution side, from practitioner side, I can say here, many of the government persons are here also. From the government side, what should be adopted to and given to the homeopathy or Ayush doctors and institutions? It was required and it is required. Most of the people, they were waiting for the vaccine or vaccination. All right, it should be. But in the last time, when it was started, it was the previous personality of the corona. And on the genetic level and DNA level, it was. Vaccine was prepared and prepared. Now you know the coronavirus always changed its personality. Vaccine was made 1 year back, which was the coronavirus and different personality. And now it is. Again, I have seen and observed. I belong to the Lucknow and SDPGI director and research director were infected with this virus after taking the first and booster dose. Both dose had been given in time and they have developed again. So the development of the immunological power, antibodies, it depends upon the, not only according to diagnostic feature, it was the coronavirus earlier, and nowadays it has been mutated, changed its personality, it is not effective in this. So our medicine, integration of that one, I can say here, and request to the government also in the way that side by side the homeopathic medicine and the administration should also be asked so that they should allot 50% to the allopathic system of medicine and the 50% to the Ayush system so that it can be observed. That how much patients you have according to the totality of the symptoms or the some sort of the selected medicine which are very similar symptoms of that COVID-19, whatsoever may be, it was earlier in the corona or at the end, it is the symptoms, now it is recorded. So, integrative condition we have to inculcate in the system how it can be developed and it can be applied. Our homeopathic medicine, it was proved on the healthy human being. And it is recorded. Many of the system, I can say very in the respective manner, that it should be proved according to their views. It should be our homeopathy system, our system of this CCRH, proven is going on, how much, how it is. It is very separate than that of the other system. We cannot apply and we cannot say we apply up the medicine, homeopathic medicine. We cannot cure. You know, many of the people, they are suffering from the diabetes and hypertension, and they are also getting the allopathic medicine. But it is the only palliative. We can say here that the integrative condition is counseling of patient properly. It should be developed. And another is that we have to make the counseling to the patient that he should change the lifestyle. These are hypertension, diabetes, cancer, joint disease. Many of the things are developed. Here we can integrate integrative condition that we have to advise and make the counseling to the patient that they should change the lifestyle. What should be? Earlier, the Rishi Manishi say that Ahara, Vihara, Vyavahara, Achara, Vichara, Asan, Vyayam, Pranayam, Yoga, Samadhi. Many of the things, it should be adopted to the patient, and it can be made by only counseling to change the lifestyle so that they can reverse to the normalities with the help of our homeopathic medicine. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Apologies for the time constraint. My next query is to Dr. Sangeeta Dugal. Ma'am, we have a short comment from your end on mainstreaming and clinical service delivery. Just 1 to 2 minutes, please. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Divya. We have to understand that medical pluralism must be accepted as a human, basic human right. We know that no single system is capable of satisfying all medical needs. Then patients should be empowered with freedom of choice for their own health. Now, popular health systems which provide holistic, patient-centric approach of treatment should be encouraged and integrated in healthcare. We have reliable, reproducible models of basic clinical research. These are to be encouraged. India has conducive environment for conducting basic research in terms like government support is there, popular choice among patients, and infrastructure and resources are available. There should be mobilization of funds for more cutting edge researches. Now supporting the homeopathy at global stage is another. Now there should be an active collaboration among researchers, professionals, organizations, educational institutions, and drug manufacturers. When we talk like in the clinical services, if we have to provide strategies, then first is like we have to provide treatment to all. We have to provide diagnostic facilities, that is laboratory or through radiology or through others. And we have to decide whether the treatment given is on standalone basis or complementary or adjuvant. The limitation of the system has to be kept in mind so that patient does not suffer and we can do the cross-reference. We should know the strengths of our system so that priority area of treatment can be decided. Now, common conditions on which the patient approached for homeopathic treatment includes non-communicable diseases, joint diseases, including rheumatoid arthritis, osteoarthritis, lifestyle diseases, diabetes, hypertension, obesity, certain skin conditions like allergies, eczema, psoriasis, diseases of children, then female and reproductive disorders, mental disorders. The most common disorder which we encounter is depression. Then patients of cerebrovascular disorders like hemiplegia, paraplegia, and certain digestive disorders, patients also come to us. When we talk about mainstreaming of Ayush, mainstreaming of Ayush and revitalization of local health tradition is one of the innovative steps for bringing untapped Ayush workforce and services into the mainstream healthcare system in India, taken by Government of India. However, its mainstreaming should not be limited to co-location of Ayush facilities with primary healthcare centers or community healthcare centers or district health centers. Rather, mainstreaming of Ayush should transcend beyond co-location to address critical issues like adequate utilization of services, proper training, orientation of Ayush workforce, an effective recruitment policy, provision of drugs and necessary equipment, and infrastructural correction in remote and rural areas. The mainstreaming of Ayush in healthcare is beneficial to society on two fronts. Firstly, it will lead to the revival of the traditional health systems, and secondly, citizens of India will benefit from healthcare services that are low cost, low technological inputs, and don't have medicinal side effects. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I'll request our DG sir, Dr. Adil Khurana, to express his views.
Actually, we are discussing integrative medicine as well as integration of homeopathy into the system, healthcare system. These are two different aspects. When we talk about integration of medicine, this is simply a functional integration, means the accessibility of homeopathic system into the healthcare stream. And this has been made possible because of government's policy of co-locations of these treatment methods available at different forums. Now, most of the AIIMS institutes are also now getting Ayush clinics into that AIIMS. But gradually, they are going to be expanded as per the public demand. And that is going to happen over a period of time. That is because of these, this is called a functional integration or cafeteria kind of approach, which is made available at different forums and different facilities. When we talk about integrative medicine, we are basically talking about treatment of two combined systems for the benefit of additional benefits to the patient actually. What happens sometimes, and it is pragmatically, if you see in the real world, this is automatically taking up. People are taking antidiabetics as well as they want to take homeopathic medicine. They are taking antihypertensive as well as they are taking homeopathic medicine for their joint pains. They are maintaining blood pressure with antihypertensives, but they do not want to take any other medicine for their joint pains. They want to take homeopathic medicine. This is going simultaneously at many forums. But the only thing that which is happening is that there is no proper documentation what kind of benefits are accrued because of these kind of approaches. So that documentation has to come up. And so that particular reason, Central Council for Research in Homeopathy, as Dr. Manchanda mentioned, there was a program of NPCDCS where in public health, such a venture has taken up in two districts, Darjeeling and Krishna districts, for homeopathy alone. And these system, homeopathic system was made available for treatment purposes in all CHCs there. And documentation has gone into detail. We have captured that information from that of those patients. Then we took up a research mode manner activity also into that part. they are combined together, how kind of, what kind of clinical benefits have accrued with these patients, that publication is now going to come out. But at many times, we have also taken up research studies where we cannot withdraw the actual conventional medicine, because we are lending them those patients to some kind of complications if you withdraw those standard care. The standard of care is to be made available. Like in COVID situation, we are not allowed to prescribe standalone homeopathy, and we are only allowed to go for an integrative manner. And that those kind of clinical trials we have taken up in various COVID treatment centers. But in case of, there are such studies on dengue, thrombocytopenia, and many other such conditions like, and there are certain studies where we have taken up that one arm has taken up conventional medicine, another arm homeopathy alone. Like in acute otitis media, we have seen that in homeopathic group, the children did not require antibiotics. They were equally effective. Homeopathy was equally effective as antibiotics in acute otitis media. This has been published in International Journal also. So there are two kind of aspects which we have to do. The policy makers have to know, we have to actually provide these kind of documentation to the policy makers, that yes, these kind of research evidences are available, where we can use adjuvant homeopathy, and we have added benefits to that. Like in acute encephalitis syndrome with BRD Medical College, the study was taken up with the institutional this management protocol, and plus homeopathy. And we compared these results between the two groups, and we could find out that with simply adding homeopathic medicine, the mortality rate has come down more than 50%. And there were no sequelae in these patients. So that if these kind of benefits can be provided by simply adding these homeopathic pills to the treatment protocol, why can't this be taken up in that manner? So such ventures, such kind of trials have been taken up, and this is a folder which we have published for you. This is will be shortly available in your kits, and you can go through. There are research evidences mentioned here in this particular folder in different areas. We have shown that adjuvant homeopathy has given an added clinical benefit to the patient. So these kind of strategies actually, what is the roadmap actually for homeopathy? That roadmap is first to build up evidence of integrative treatment. Simultaneously, if there is a facility available for co-locations of that particular, there should be appropriate cross-reference, respected cross-reference between the systems. And the third aspect which we have not taken up till now is intra-Ayush collaboration. We have not taken up. Although we philosophically, we are holistic medicine, Ayurveda, Yunani, Yoga and Naturopathy. But we have not taken up any integrative research or any trial such within the intra-Ayush systems. So that we are now going to initiate with that. Government policies also coming up for that. Why not to go for intra-Ayush collaboration? So these aspects will be as a part of strategy, and National Health Policy 2017 has already envisaged that we should go for that kind of a model for intra-Ayush collaboration as well as inter-system collaboration with allopathy also. So that is taking place, and more research evidences we are trying to build up. Third aspect, which is most important aspect, is with the whenever we start actually giving medicine to a patient, and we know that he is taking antidiabetic, and suddenly because of our own fundamentalist kind of approach, we withdraw those medicines. Oh, homeopathy will take care of it, don't worry. And what happens? The patient goes into complications. And that brings bad name to the homeopathy has worsened the condition. So this kind of a study was also published in one of the journals where side effects of homeopathy medicines are traced out. Actually, it was not side effects of homeopathy. The 4% side effects which were reported there in that particular article from various studies, the author mentioned that it was actually not directly linked to the homeopathic medication, but actually it was because of sudden withdrawal of their allopathic medicines, and that patient got worsened for the developed complications. So being homeopaths, qualified homeopaths, we know the science and progress of the disease. Why not to take gradual tapering off unless you see the right kind of a clinical benefit is coming up? So those things we have to take care. So these three aspects I wanted to highlight. When we talk of integration, and the integration.
ये वाली
तो आप वहाँ से आउट लेके
मैं आपको ना फोटो भेज दूंगा, आप ना नंबर से ना मेरा नंबर
है
ना हाई लिख कर भेज दो, व्हाट्सएप नंबर मेरा चार्ज भी लगा
हुआ,
फोटो भेज दूंगा आपको मैं।
Dr. Khurana, that we should learn referral system. We should not keep all the patient in one hand. If time required, you refer the case, whether it should be referred to homeopath or Ayurveda chart or modern medicine. Referral system, we must know, we should not keep all the patient in our hand. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Not those policy right now, but we are going to take up our own, that we want to take up such collaborative studies with other systems also now, like for with the Ayurveda, with the yoga naturopathy. Yoga naturopathy has already been invited in NPCDCS program. We are homeopathy and lifestyle management through yoga therapy, that has been taken up, but we have not gone into those kind of a proper scientific studies in that manner, that we are going to take up now.
Thank you. Well, it's a session. What is this?
Just to follow that, we have undertaken homeopathy, drug proving and clinical verification of n number of Ayurvedic drugs. So in that way, that kind of intra-Ayush collaboration is also happening. In that we need to work on further. Yes.
Yeah. Well, we do have, I mean, other drugs also, which are from there. But my question was, like the policy which you've been talking about, the intra-Ayush, I mean, system, or if we just have the basic understanding of each system to the doctors, so that they can very rightly understand if this is in the domain of this particular system of medicine, or this is this particular domain of system of medicine, rather than lingering on one particular patient for a longer period of time, and ultimately it is the patient who suffers the maximum, and the society also. If we can, at a one particular level, understand and take one particular patient combinedly and see what best can be done, or any particular patient who has been lying for a longer period of time, the other system of medicine should be invited over to see if they can help. I think that will give us a much better understanding for the patient to work upon, and for the patient welfare. Thank you.
Okay. I just wanted to add into this information. You must have listened to Dr. Bhushan Patwardhan initially. He is actually the member of that working group which is constituted under NITI Aayog for integrative medicine, actually. And there are three groups, one on research, one on education, and one on clinical practice. And in the education side, now they are coming out with a policy where they will be orienting Ayush doctors with allopathic concepts in the initial first year, and similarly to the allopathic doctors about the Ayush system in the first year, so that they know each other's system strengths and their concepts, philosophies. This is going to part. This is going to come up as a curriculum into all these systems.
All system of medicine, there was a policy made, and all the systems are working on integrating yoga, even for the modern medicine.
Yoga being a non-interventional medicine.
Policy has been made for.
Yoga being a non-interventional medicine is going to be taken up by all systems now.
So that will be
Yes, it is there. We propose now. Dr. Bharti wanted to say.
In case you are not able to, some of the two or three points that Dr. Gupta and Dr. Sitesh that I have mentioned, clear cut approach, when we are talking of integration, there have to be proper guidelines as to when not to take it. And they should be applicable to all systems of medicine.